Welcome to the 9th Battle of Sea Encounters Cold War. Today we have Collard's Water Fleet, this one cruiser, and a pair of frigates, against Jono's Royal Australian Navy. You might actually see Collard's epic anti-air in action. And here is Jono's fleet with a lot of different boats. Oh. Let's begin the battle! It doesn't actually lag too much. Yay! A match that won't be a slideshow for the first 3 minutes of a battle. Missiles from Collard's side. Let's see, will we lock on to the enemy? No. Excellent. What the fuck? Oh yes, of course. Colossus likes to shoot his own boat. I forgot. Well, let's hope that Colossus' detection equipment doesn't get wrecked.
Launch the heat seekers.
Now there's definitely stuff locking on. Let's see, what is the gun, what are the guns on Collard's ship firing at? Appears like the carrier. Ah yes, Collard's anti-air. Better. Call out your missiles missed. All of them. I have no idea where they're actually going. Oh. Ah, more anti-air missiles. Oh, I hit. Yes, this fucking course. But just when the anti-air missiles really don't like to go for a target you intended them to go for. And so far. Oh, CAWS fire. Yellow tracers! Everywhere! Holy fuck, that's a lot of tracers. Well, how to reduce my FPS 101. Fuck, that's a lot of tracers. Submarine from Jono, as per usual, dequeuing itself. The carrier with holes in it from Collard's guns. And some really low FPS, because that's a fucking load of tracers. I expected the anti-air missiles on Collard's boat to actually work more effectively. Sad. one of the fish stamps is getting rammed. Nice. Well, Jono, your planes are successful at killing my FPS in conjunction with Callout's fleet. Oh, well. All that, well, every ship on Jono's side is slightly damaged. And, well. Apparently that's a lot of flares on Jono's side, if all the missiles are going for the flares. I think single pixel IR is what I'd mean better in this case. Instead of IR seekers, I think what you're using. Let me actually check. Yup, a single pixels would have been more effective, I would say, in this case, because we are less prone to seeing a random target somewhere far away. If they're a smaller field of view. Well, at least it's a nice display of fireworks and pretty lights in the sky. Well, those missiles are actually trying to track, but failed epically. Ooh, missiles. Ooh, heavy missiles. Let's see what the missiles will do. But obviously, Jono's side is receiving more damage so far, just it's still not a lot. Most of the ships on Jono's side appear more to damage themselves than receive damage from the enemy, other than the Blossom. And the missiles got jammed. They're definitely going for a decoy. Well, Ay. Jono's guns appear to be rather ineffective compared to Call-Out's, but Apollo's guns so far are just targeting the carrier. The carrier has definitely a lot of holes in it. These are anti-air missiles, I think. As they're going for some decoy over here. My spotter has got hit by something, apparently. Oh, torpedoes. Yeah, fly spotter is getting hit by torpedoes. A pair of Stacys are dequeuing themselves, that's of course epic. Oh no, Bullet's detection tower got taken out. I'm still confused why only two go for intended target. If better things of one turn, then they're all the same. I think at least. Yeah. Well, I'm confused. So I would guess that we got jammed, there might be a decoy somewhere over there, blowing up into the sky. These are missiles from a corvettes, I think. That should be missiles from corvettes that just hit. Stacy's still dequeuing themselves, or did they stop? Are these the Stacy's? No, those are Charlene's. The Stacy's, I would guess, are back there. Oh, some CAWS fire against actual missiles, I would think. Again, then, some bad annoying firefighter. Hitting you. Nice. Kamikazes. Apparently the Royal Australian Navy also uses kamikazes, I didn't know that. I thought kamikazes were a Japanese thing. More missiles from the corvettes. und es soll gepusht, verfehlt und gepusht auch weg von werden. Ja, Torpedo selber. Ne, think this were intended to be anti-air missiles. According to the damage. El Jono definitely got a lot of decoys, so that helped him a lot to defend against a lot of missiles. So you have a gun on the corvettes fire and corvettes frigates. Yes, we are. Well, after the carrier gets destroyed, then I think the rest of Jono's fleet will possibly feel the might of the guns of Colob's fleet, but it's actually getting pounded itself now. And it's capsizing. Well, it's actually close enough now for the guns on Jono's fleet to be effective. Anti-air missiles that are actually going for their targets, but missed anyways.
I lost the bomb! Do you have it?
Got some short range missiles. That all missed.
Kaboom!
I think that's the anti-air firepower and Colob's ship destroyed. That was definitely a lot of pain. Interesting, we actually got to a very close range for once. Wait, are these... They don't have guidance. These are depth charges. No, rocket propelled depth charges. Interesting. That explains why we miss so hard. And why we have such short range. So the target prioritization should definitely be a bit different. Yeah, also capsized successfully. And you're now shooting away your bow. Have you capsized successfully? Yes, you have also capsized successfully. Excellent, the entirety of Colt's fleet has capsized successfully. The cruiser has uncapsized for some reason. Thank you. have a gun that targeting the wrong target. And there is definitely no missiles on this cruiser. This corvette frigate is shooting itself. And this one probably too. It's actually not shooting at all, okay, it's shooting itself. Interesting. Well, it definitely appears like all is doing more damage if it would target the correct ship. Oh wait, the ravine. What the fuck happened to the ravine? Is this a ravine? No, it's a Charlie. This is also a Charlie. That's a ravine. Yeah, that's a Darwin. It got hit by something, not sure what, but it got hit by something. It's not pretty. The carrier is about to DQ. Finally. Destroyed by the firepower of Kolob's gun and the missiles of the corvettes. Aha! The CAWS is firing against the ship! When you're so close that your CAWS fires. It just seems kinda ineffective. Good, what are the guns targeting now? That's a good question. Still the carrier. Oh. Carrier is gone, stop targeting carrier, you piece of shit. I can actually pause it to make it DQ faster. Let's see. Why are you still targeting? Carrier is dead, you stupid piece of shit. Why are you shooting yourself? You're stupid. You're getting shot. Finish the carrier disappearing because it's bullshit. That also increases my FPS, so that's nice. There's a ship in front of you, target it. Why are you stupid? Ah, yes, finally. Well, now at least I have FPS with the carrier gone. Interesting if this thing will actually survive. Because its firepower is degraded, to say the least. And it's shooting itself. Thank you. Okay, this frigate I would expect is also shooting itself, or it's not shooting anything. No. This one? This one's dead. The fight as well, okay. Good, or what are these two doing with Stasis? Stasis are shooting away with everything they got. And the missiles are successfully going into the water. Against decoys, apparently, or something. Probably decoys. Some torpedoes. It's against one of the uncapsized. I got it. Uncapsized frigates. Pew, 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 pew. Do you still have a rudder? No, that explains a lot. Oh, the Darlene is gone and... That's interesting. The Darlene apparently sunk or something. Or just was too far away without moving. You're firing at the missiles that are being stupid decoyed. I don't even know where a decoy is. Yeah, well, I don't know what their guidance is. But apparently they're stupid. Is this gonna be a draw? Or a loss of offensive action on both sides? Again? It appears so. Because literally nothing is happening now. Elconaut's ship definitely still has ammo, but it cannot target anything. We still have ammo, but I think we remember already an issue where you stopped firing at a certain amount of ammo. Oh, Claude's corvette is firing. Yeah, why do we call them for corvettes or frigates or for fuck's sake? Oh, we're actually out of ammo as well. Well, that explains some. This thing still has ammo. Can I shoot at something? I think these ones? Not quite sure what's shooting at. I think Acid has lost most of its detection. If not all. It's somewhat blind now. Loss of offensive action on both sides, basically. Yeah, literally zero ammo. That's all the frigate. One frigate. There's a cruiser. There's another frigate. That probably also has like almost zero ammo. Oh yes. We need more ammo. Hey, even CWS is firing at something. And not anymore. Sad. Oh. It's just taking off the railings. Yeah, well, that's not a lot of damage on the CAWS. But hey, at least firing. Really not much happening. Other than taking down some parts of the bridge, it's not doing much. You're dry. You are probably dry as well. Yep. Ammo gone. Like firing something. Oh, the main guns are firing. They are firing. Again. And did some damage. 2 minutes remaining in the battle. Obviously not much is gonna happen. Another plane.
Cannon gebaut.
Flame gone. Yeah. Interesting, to say the least. A draw in favor of Kolod's fleet, having destroyed the carrier. And sinking the Darlene somehow, and almost, well, doing significant damage to one of the Charlenes. And that's about it, and well, Kolod's fleet's just doing their usual, not wanting to be in right side up. At all. Another loss of offensive action draw.